I've actually had some close calls with lithium batteries, such as this one. My friend actually had an RC car and he went to go charge his battery, and they suspected that the battery caused his garage to literally burn down.
Lithium polymer batteries use a different kind of electrolyte, and their relatively lightweight makes them ideal for gadgets like Jesse's pal's ill-fated RC car.
Now that we're moving on to our bigger batteries that can release toxic fumes, we have to wear respirators. Safety first, right guys?
This is lithium polymer RC battery. In 3, 2, 1.
Contact!
Oh, it's smoking! Oh God, oh my God.
Stop!
It's the proof they need that a lithium-based battery can ignite under pressure. And when you're on a roll.
Hey, let's try this one.
Oh, what is that?
Same as before, lithium polymer, just bigger.
All right. That looks scary.
It's around twice the voltage of the battery that just went up in smoke.
Valerie, are you ready for this?
Yes.
All right, this is bigger lithium polymer. In 3, 2, 1. Here we go.
Contact!
It looks like the muncher has only succeeded in making another lithium flapjack. Until.
Ooh. Oh my goodness.
Wow.
That is a lot of smoke.
Wow.
Oh my God.
And you know the old saying, where there's smoke, there's generally.
Oh, it's on fire!
We have a fire!
We have a fire now!
The FLIR camera confirms that they've got what they wanted. High pressure combustion.
We got sparks, smoke, and even fire. Awesome for us, but not so great for our garbage man. We also found out the higher the voltage the battery was at, we got more explosive results.
The higher voltage creates a higher current when shorted, which generates a higher temperature,